नेक्स्ट टाइप ऑफ पायरोलिसिस ऑफ अल्केन इज द क्रैकिंग. ओके सो सेकेंड इज रिमेन, सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द क्रैकिंग. सो दिस इज द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ दिस पायरोलिसिस ऑफ क्रैकिंग. सो वॉट इज द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ क्रैकिंग? इन द क्रैकिंग बोथ कार्बन हाइड्रोजन एंड कार्बन कार्बन बॉन्ड ब्रेक. ओके सो बोथ कार्बन एंड कार्बन कार्बन एंड कार्बन हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड गेट ब्रेक, राइट? ओके सो दिस इज द क्रैकिंग. सो लेट अस टेक द एग्जाम्पल्स. ओके सो आई एम गोइंग टू टेक द एग्जाम्पल. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, so I have taken the example as such, the ethane, right? Okay, so when this ethane is heated in the absence of air, right? So when this ethane is heated in the absence of air, so at about 423 to 623 Kelvin again. Okay, so not necessary to use the silica alumina catalyst here, right? Okay, so in the cracking, both the carbon-carbon as well as carbon-hydrogen bond is going to get break. So see here, suppose I want to break this carbon-hydrogen bond, this carbon-hydrogen bond, right? Okay, what I will get? So I will get, so this is the CH2 double bond, CH2, so that is the ethylene plus hydrogen gas, right? Okay, so as well as carbon carbon bond get break. Okay, there is again a breaking of carbon carbon bond, so that is the cracking. In the cracking, both the carbon carbon as well as carbon hydrogen bond going to get break. Okay, so here see, so this is the dehydrogenation, but carbon carbon as well as carbon hydrogen bond is going to get break. So how this can be carried out? So see here, so this carbon carbon bond is break, right? Okay, so again what will happen? So as this carbon carbon bond is going to get break, what will happen? So this carbon hydrogen bond is going to get break as well as, right? Okay, so let us take the another example that will help you to satisfied or understand very easily, that is the propane, right? Okay, so this is the propane. So in the cracking, both the carbon hydrogen and carbon carbon bond is break. So therefore this is the carbon carbon bond is going to get break, right? So carbon carbon bond is break, as well as this carbon hydrogen bond is also break, right? Okay, so therefore what will happen? So this is the CH2, right? Okay, here double bond, so CH2, right, plus, so this CH3 and one hydrogen atom, that is the CH4, so you will get the ethylene and ethane. Okay, so in the dehydrogenation, alkene plus hydrogen gas is the product, whereas in the cracking, alkene and alkane are the product. Okay, so what are the products? So this is the first thing. Second thing, what are the product? Alkane and alkene are the product, whereas in the dehydrogenation, alkene and hydrogen gas is the product, whereas in the cracking, alkene and alkane are the product. Why this happen? Because carbon carbon bond is break as well as carbon hydrogen bond is break. So this is the propane. Now let us take the another example. So if I am going to take the next example, that is the butane, right? Okay, so see here, n-butane. So this is the CH3, right? Okay, then this is the CH2 and CH3, right? Okay, so what is the hint for the cracking method? both carbon carbon as well as carbon hydrogen bond break. So suppose I want to break this bond from this here carbon carbon bond, okay, then what will happen? So I have to break this carbon hydrogen bond also. You cannot break the carbon hydrogen bond from here because already you are going to break these two carbon carbon bond, right? Okay, so it indicate that once the carbon carbon bond is break from these two, you cannot break the hydrogen from this carbon atom. You have to break the hydrogen from the next of this carbon carbon bond breaking carbon. So therefore this carbon carbon bond is break, so therefore next hydrogen atom is break from this carbon atom, that the adjacent carbon, this is the adjacent carbon to this carbon atom. So therefore what will happen? See here, this is the CH3, okay, then CH, right? So as this carbon hydrogen bond is break, this carbon carbon bond is break, to satisfy the valency you have to place the double bond. So therefore this is the propylene, right? Okay, then this CH3 and this hydrogen is attached to this carbon, so you will get the methane, right? Okay, so therefore what is the hint for the cracking carbon carbon and carbon hydrogen bond break? Alkane and alkene are the product. This is the alkene and this is the alkane, right? Okay, suppose you want to break the bond carbon carbon from here, what will happen? See, again I will write the n-butane, right? Okay, so this is the n-butane. Okay, so you can break the carbon carbon bond from here also. This is the n-butane. Okay, so therefore if I want to break the bond carbon carbon from here, you can break it. Okay, so what is our rule? If you break the carbon carbon bond, so from this carbon and from this carbon, you cannot remove the hydrogen atom. You remove the hydrogen or remove the or break the bond from this carbon carbon hydrogen atom. So therefore what will happen again? So this is the CH2, right? Okay, here you have to put the double bond to satisfy the valency. So therefore this is the hydrogen atom, right? So this molecule is the ethylene molecule, right? Plus again what happened? So this carbon carbon bond break, so this is the CH2 again, hydrogen bond is break. Okay, so how the ethane is produced? So this ethylene is produced, so this hydrogen is added to this carbon atom, so therefore ethylene and ethane are the product. So therefore this is the ethylene and this is the ethane. So therefore if you want to break the if you want to carry out the cracking of the n-butane, you will have the four product: propylene, methane, if you break the bond from here, if you break the bond from this carbon carbon bond, you will get ethylene and ethane. So therefore n-butane, in the absence of air at about 423 to 623 Kelvin, you will get these four product, right? Okay, so have you understood how the cracking method is carried out? So I have taken the two examples, that is the propylene and pentylene, propylene, propane and the butane. So you can solve the questions from the n-pentane and from the isopentane, etc., right? Okay, so this is regarding the examples. So now third example we can take. Okay, so third example I will take here, so that is the branched alkene. See here, I am going to take the branched alkene. So suppose this is the CH3 CH3, then this is the CH3H, right? Okay, so this is the isobutane. So what will happen if the isobutane of cracking is carried out? Okay, so how, what is the main reason, main theme? Both the carbon hydrogen and carbon carbon bond break, alkane and alkene are the product, right? Okay, so see here, so this is the isobutane, so break this carbon carbon bond, right? Okay, so as well as you have to break the carbon hydrogen bond also, right? Okay, so this carbon hydrogen bond and carbon carbon bond is break, so instead of this isobutane you will take the isopentane. So we'll take the another example, so branch chain, that is the isopentane, not the isobutane. So this is the CH3 EH, CH2 and this is the CH3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is the isopentane. Okay, we will take this example. Right, so this is the isopentane. So now, what is the condition? Condition is you have to break the carbon-carbon as well as carbon-hydrogen bond. So this carbon-carbon bond is break, as well as this carbon-hydrogen bond is break. Right, what you will have? So you will have CH3, CH3 double bond, CH2. CH3, this carbon, CH3, CH3, okay. So this carbon-carbon bond is break, this carbon-hydrogen bond break, you have to place the double bond. So then this CH3 and this hydrogen 1, they comes out in the form of methane. So therefore, you will have this isobutylene and methane is the product. Right? Okay. If you want to break the bond from this carbon-carbon bond, you can also break this. Okay, you can also break this carbon hydrogen bond is also okay. So this carbon carbon bond is break, and then this carbon hydrogen bond is break. What will happen? See, CH3, CH3, H, okay, CH2, CH3, right? Okay, suppose you want to break this carbon carbon bond, okay, so you can break this carbon carbon bond also. Right? Okay. If you break this carbon-carbon bond, you cannot break the hydrogen bond from this carbon atom. So next carbon is, or next adjacent carbon from this is this one or this one. So either you have to break the carbon-hydrogen bond from this or either from this. Right? CH3. Okay. So see, I am going to break the carbon-hydrogen bond from this carbon. So what you will have? You will have this CH3 and this hydrogen comes out in the form of methane. Right. Then this CH3 is as it is. Right. Then this carbon CH. Right. This CH3CH. Here you have to place the double bond. So that is the CH and this CH3 is as it is. Right. Okay. So this is called as the, this is the methane. And this is the 1, 2, 3, 4, that is the butene, right? Okay, so this is the isopentane, this is also isopentane. If you break this carbon-carbon bond, you will have isobutene and methane. If you break this carbon-carbon bond, you will have the methane and butene. Okay, so these are the three examples I have taken. So next example, that is the n-pentane, isopentane, neopentane examples, you can solve at your home. Okay, do this practice. So otherwise you cannot understand the reactions in the organic chemistry unless and until you are self not writing the reaction, you will not get the idea regarding the concept. If you are only looking the reactions and reading the books, you cannot have the command on the reaction. You have to self write reaction like this and solve such a questions. Okay, yes, this is regarding the cracking part, that is the whole process, that is the pyrolysis. So now pyrolysis are of two type: dehydrogenation, removal of hydrogen molecule only, and product are the ethylalkene and the hydrogen molecule. Whereas in the pyrolysis, products are alkene and alkene, both carbon carbon and carbon hydrogen bond is to be break. Right? Okay. So last part of this topic and last reaction of this topic, that is the aromatization. Okay, so this is the aromatization. Okay, there is very important reaction. So this is the aromatization. So in the first topic, that is general organic chemistry, you have already learned that aromatic compounds are those compounds which contain the benzene ring. What is mean by aromatic compounds? Aromatic compounds are those compounds which contain at least one benzene ring are called as aromatic compound. So this is the definition of aromatic compound. So here you have to get the aromatic compound from the different substrate molecules. So we will see the reaction. So aromatic compound, that is the benzene. So this is the structure of benzene, right? Okay, 6 carbon atoms are present. Then each carbon atom is attached by the hydrogen atom. okay, each carbon atom is attached by the hydrogen atom, so there is a double bond in between the carbon atom, so therefore the valency of each carbon atom is getting satisfied. 1 2 3 4, this carbon valency, 1 2 3 4, this 1 2 3 4, this one 1 2 3 4, this one 1 2 3 4, okay, so every carbon atom satisfied its valency, tetravalency, right? So this is called as benzene, or it is also called as arene. This is also called as the arene, or it is also called as the benzene, right? Okay, so when this benzene is to be heated, okay, so this product, that this is the aromatic compound, so this is the benzene product, okay, so this is the aromatic compound. So how this aromatic compound is to be prepared? So this aromatic compound is to be prepared from the aromatization of the carbon atom from the carbon number 6, okay. So aromatization of alkane can be carried out those alkane which have at least the 6 carbon atom. From the 6 carbon atom we can carry out the aromatization, okay. So this is the aromatic compound benzene or arene. So this product is obtained from the carbon 6 containing alkene. So carbon 6 containing alkene is the so that is the hexane, okay. So this is the hexane carbon. See, so how many carbon? 6, 1 2 3 4, right? Okay, 6. How many carbon atoms? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 carbon atoms are there. So, this is the hydrogen. This is the hydrogen. Okay, the valency of this carbon atom is satisfied. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so here 2 hydrogen atoms is to be attached. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, this is to be attached. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, this is 1, 2, 3, and this 1, 4. So, this is the 1. This is 2. Right, okay, so 1 2 3 4, so this is called as n-hexane, right? Okay, so which method we have to carry out? Aromatization or reforming. This is also called as reforming process. This aromatization is also called as reforming process. So what are the catalysts used? Generally the metal oxides are used, so that is the molybdenum trioxide or vanadium pentoxide, okay, vanadium pentoxide V2O5, okay. So therefore these are the metal oxides. So this is carried out at about 773 Kelvin temperature, okay. So then what is the atmospheric pressure? 10 to 20 atmospheric pressure, right? So when this n-hexane is heated with the metal oxides, so metal oxides, molybdenum trioxide, you know, or this vanadium pentoxide, okay, so that is the alumina Al2O3, alumina trioxide, so this Al2O3 is also used. So these are the metal oxides. So temperature must be 773 Kelvin. Then what is the atmospheric pressure? Atmospheric pressure is 10 to 20 atmospheric pressure. So aromatization require these conditions, right? Okay, so generally in the aromatization, what is to be removed? So hydrogen atom is to be removed. See how the hydrogen atom is to be removed. So here, so this carbon hydrogen, right? So this is to be removed, right? So then this carbon hydrogen is to be removed, right? So this carbon hydrogen is to be removed, right? So this carbon hydrogen is to be removed, right? Okay, so therefore what happened? This carbon atom is there. So to remove this carbon, to remove this hydrogen molecule, there is a formation of bond between this carbon carbon. So there is a bond is produced, see here, okay. So between these two carbon atom, single bond is there, single bond is there, single bond produced, carbon hydrogen, this carbon hydrogen, so this carbon one hydrogen, this carbon one hydrogen, this carbon one hydrogen, this carbon has one hydrogen, right? Okay, so this carbon has only one hydrogen. So now as we are going to remove the hydrogen, so that is the dehydrogenation process. So to remove the one hydrogen, one bond should be placed. So here one bond should be placed, one double bond. So in between these two carbon atom, you have to place the double bond, because you remove the hydrogen molecule between these two carbon atom. So we have placed the double bond. So in between these two carbon atom, we have removed the hydrogen, so we have to place the double bond, right? Okay, so this is called as the benzene or arene. This is the aromatization. So what do you mean by aromatization? So aromatization is the process in which when the alkane containing 6 or more than 6 carbon atom is heated at about 773 Kelvin by using the atmospheric pressure 10 to 20 and using the catalyst, that is the metal oxides, molybdenum trioxide or this alumina trioxide or vanadium pentoxide or chromium trioxide. Okay, so these are the metal catalyst. Then what will happen? There is a removal of hydrogen molecule and there is a formation of aromatic compound. So that process is called as aromatization or reforming process. So here, how many hydrogen you have removed? This one hydrogen molecule, 1, 2, 3, 4. Four hydrogen molecule are removed. So therefore, each double bond requires the one hydrogen molecule. So therefore, here you will have the benzene or arene is the final product, right? Okay. So this is the first example. So now, if another example you can take, many examples you can take, because after the carbon number 6, aromatization takes place. From the carbon number 6, you can say, from the carbon number 6. So this is the 6 carbon atom containing compound N-hexane. Suppose I want to take the carbon containing the alkane containing the carbon 7. Okay, suppose I want to take the alkane containing the carbon number 7. See here. Okay, so this is the CH3. So then this CH2, CH2, so this is the CH2, okay, then here the carbon, okay, so this is the carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and this one, 7, so here is a hydrogen, CH3, okay, you have to write the carbon and hydrogen in a ring form, so therefore, this is the hydrogen, this is the another hydrogen, okay, so this is the hydrogen, so here hydrogen is there, so this is CH3, then this is the 1, 2, 3, 4, another hydrogen atom is there, okay, CH3, CH2, 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 CH3, right, so this is called as N-hexane, right, okay, so this is the N-hexane. So now, when this N-hexane is heated with the metal oxide, molybdenum trioxide or vanadium pentoxide or chromium trioxide, so at about 773 Kelvin by using the 10 to 20 atmospheric pressure, okay, by using the 10 to 20 atmospheric pressure, so reforming or aromatization means removal of hydrogen molecule, so therefore, this hydrogen molecule is removed. Okay, so then again this carbon hydrogen bond is to be carbon hydrogen, and this carbon hydrogen, that is this hydrogen molecule removed, so this hydrogen molecule is to be removed, right? Okay, so then this hydrogen is to be removed, right? Okay, so see what you will get. You will get, so this is the CH3 is as it is, right? This is the CH3, so this is the carbon, this carbon atom is there, okay, so this is the carbon, this carbon, okay, so therefore this is the carbon and this has the hydrogen, this carbon hydrogen, then next this is the carbon which has one hydrogen atom, then this carbon which has again one hydrogen atom, right? Okay, so then this is the carbon, this carbon, okay, so there is a bond between this carbon atom takes place due to the removal of hydrogen, so this hydrogen molecule is removed, so therefore this carbon carbon bond, so this carbon carbon new bond is produced, so this carbon has only one hydrogen, again this carbon has only one hydrogen, okay, so now what is necessary to place the double bond? So see here, this carbon, these two hydrogen removed, there is a formation of bond, but these two hydrogen removed in between these two, so in between these two carbon atom, one hydrogen is removed, so you have to place the double bond here, Okay, then in between these two carbon atoms, hydrogen molecule is removed. You have to place the one double bond, right? Then this, in between these two carbon atoms, one double bond is placed. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. How many molecules of hydrogen gas is to be removed? 4 molecules of hydrogen gas. So this is called as methyl benzene. This compound is called as methyl benzene, general name, and the common as well as IUPAC name is toluene. So this compound can be written as, this compound can be written as, so double bond here, here CH3, right? Okay, so this compound is called as the toluene compound. Right. Okay. So aromatization of 7 carbon containing alkene can be carried out. The aromatization of 8 carbon containing alkene can be carried out. So you do the examples of carbon number 7, carbon number 8 containing alkene at your home. So I have taken the 2 examples, provided that these conditions are very necessary. Okay. So this is regarding the aromatization of alkene. Right? Okay. So this aromatization of alkane is the final reaction. So here we have finished the topic, that is the alkane topic. Right? Okay. So hydrocarbon contain the alkane, alkene, alkyne, and aromatic compound at the benzene. So hydrocarbon contain the 4 topic. Out of that, alkane we have finished here. Okay, so now student, what you have to do at your home? So as alkane we have completed. So how to study this topic, alkane? So therefore, first of all, you have to revise the topic. Okay, how you revise the topic? So first of all, in the alkane topic, what you have seen, that is the introductory part, introduction you have seen. In this introduction, what is mean by alkane, what is the general molecular formula of alkane, why are the alkane is called as paraffin, that part we have seen. Then second is the classification of alkane, okay. Classification of alkane. So there are two types of alkane, straight chain alkane and branch chain alkanes. Okay, so therefore straight chain alkane and branch chain alkanes are the types of alkanes that you have seen. Now third part is the nomenclature of alkane. Okay, so we have studied the nomenclature of alkane, common name system, IUPAC system that we have seen. Then next is the nature of carbon atom. We have studied already. So nature of carbon atom, primary carbon atom, secondary carbon atom, tertiary carbon atom and quaternary carbon atom, that part you have studied. So next part what you have studied is the alkyl group. Okay, so what do you mean by alkyl group? What are the types of alkyl group? Primary alkyl group, secondary alkyl group, tertiary alkyl group, then this definition of alkyl group that you have studied. So next part what you have studied, so next is the general isomerism we have studied. Okay, so that is the isomerism. Okay, so generally chain isomerism of alkane you have already studied. So next part is the general methods of preparation of alkane, general methods of preparation of alkane. So this part also you have studied, general methods of preparation of alkane. So there are different methods, decarboxylation method that you have studied. Then the second is the Wood's reaction by reduction of alkyl halide you have studied. Then next is the unsaturated hydrocarbon you have studied. Okay, so next is the, these are the preparation of alkane. So next part is the chemical reactions of alkane, chemical reactions of alkane. So chemical reactions of alkane, so chemical reactions for halogenation, nitration, then aromatization, then oxidation, and then last is the, that is the pyrolysis of alkane. So this is the topic we have covered, all this part. right? Okay, so this should be very important. So you go through these all parts, you study it. I have taken the examples of MCQ also. Okay, so this topic we have concluded. So next topic, alkene, will be studied in the next video. Thank you.